What's up? What you got for me, D?
I'm not trying to hold you accountable.
Why not? I thought you was gonna hold me accountable.
No. I agree with much of what you said. I do have a question though.
Okay, go ahead. You got it for me or you got it for Freezy or both of us?
Both of y'all.
Okay.
It don't matter. So I'm one of the people who is doomed for life according to you, which is fine. I understand that.
How old are you?
And I'm 52.
Okay. Do you feel like you're doomed for life, or do you just think that I said it and it's wrong?
Well, I actually don't know anymore. It's not the way that I came into it, right? So, I mean, the question I want to ask, and then I can explain anything if need be. But the question I want to ask is, I'm not blaming anybody else, because once you turn 18, you have free cause to make your own decisions.
Mm-hmm.
But the way that I was brought into this world and the things that happened to me as a woman, it's not special or different than a whole lot of women my age.
Okay.
You know, a lot of back closet stuff. I have never been a virgin. So I was never gonna be, you know, the upstanding wife. I've always had a horrible relationship with sex because I was taught through watching life and through relationships with men and my mom's boyfriends and so on and so forth, that the way that a man shows love is by touching you, okay? By sex.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I realized that was different, it was already kind of too late. I was already married.
So you were married before?
Yeah, this is the pastor's wife. So,
oh, this is D Moore.
Yeah.
How you doing, D? Okay, good to see you. Okay.
So, I thought that I was doing the right thing and all of that type of stuff when I got married, so on and so forth. All of that, we all know how that went down. But anyway, now that I'm here, right? The question is, am I doomed? Because I never had a good relationship with sex and men in the first place. I never was taught that. My mom was one of those single moms. She really could care less, you know, about me or my brother or my sister.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, like I said, this was way before now. So like even when I was growing up, we didn't do the stuff that the little girls do now. And it wasn't never my intention to have sex, to just be out here, you know what I'm saying, flaunting it and throwing it and blah, blah, blah. That was never, most of the, at that time, it really wasn't the intention of, you know, for you to just be out here hoeing. Like that was looked down upon when I was growing up. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
If you was out here flaunting it, then we all knew, okay, you a video hoe, whatever, whatever. I mean, the most we had out back then was what, Lil' Kim maybe and Trina. Right. So it was just different. And it wasn't like it is now. Even the people who were entertainers, they were always dressed. You know, you wouldn't never have a whole bunch of girls just out here letting it all hang out. And all the stuff that's going on, I'm traditional in my heart. And I never wanted life to go down the way that it did. And I'm not. And I know I saw a whole lot of comments about me, you know, being for the streets, blah, blah, blah. I've never been that person. Right. And I've worked really hard to get where I am today, not because I wanted to, because I absolutely never wanted to be a quote unquote strong black woman. Never. That was never my, I've got married. I wanted to have a husband. Yes, I needed to contribute to the house. Proverbs 31 tells you straight up who you're supposed to be. So I contributed to the house like I was supposed to. I've been working since I was 13. So you know what I'm saying? There's no way, because my mom didn't provide what I needed. So I started working early. So You know what I'm saying? There is no way that I would have ever been the woman that you guys are considering that woman. You know what I mean? That
what do you rise. What do you when the last time that you actually talked to a guy?
I have a
I know. You got some people that you're rocking with right now.
No, not people. No, I have one. I don't do people. I have one that I've been with for 5 years. And he's
so why he ain't marry you?
That's huh?
Why he ain't marry you?
Cause you here we go. This is what got me in trouble last time, answering questions.
No, you asked the question, are you doomed? I need some context.
He's too young.
So he won't marry you because he's too young.
Oh no, he wants to marry me. I don't want to marry him because he's
too old young. How old is too young?
Come on, don't.
Don't come up. No. You can't answer no question and not add the context.
He's 33. Yeah,
you ain't got to tell us his name or nothing.
Yeah, we answer his name.
He's 33.
Okay, so he's 33. Yes. Where you find this guy at? 33 wanting to marry a 52-year-old woman?
Yes. His mom introduced us.
Is he autistic?
Huh?
Is he autistic?
No.
You sure?
I'm positive.
Okay, go ahead. His mom introduced y'all and what?
And it was supposed to just be for fun, and then it ended up going to where it is now.
What do you mean his mom introduced y'all and it was supposed to be for fun?
She introduced us as in not on purpose, but then he told her that I was super cute or whatever. And then she was like, okay, come over and play some, you know, cards or whatever. And then I did. And then.
So why you won't marry? Why you won't marry him? What's wrong with him?
Because he doesn't have any children. I'm done with children. He's going to eventually want children. I don't want to take his life from him like that. I don't want to do that.
So why are you fucking him then?
Cause at first it was just for some fun. I just young was having dick. Some fun, huh?
No, listen, Freezy. I'm about to get back to the original question, and I'm asking you context for a reason.
Okay.
You know why you doomed?
Because I'm having sex out of wedlock.
Nope. Because you're not a wife. You got the mentality of a city girl still. And that's the reason why you see, the reason why older women are doomed is not that they can't have a guy. It's not that they're not making themselves available. It's because the mentality that they have, and they will fuck around with a guy for the next 5 years, understanding that they're not even the person that they should be with. That's not the person that they should be with in the first place. You ruining his life from 28 to 33. This man think that you love him. You just was looking at him as a boy toy. You fucking around with him, and you ain't got the mentality of a wife. Because you already know that you ain't going to marry a dude that married his dude in the first place. So,
but are I, you, but are, he no, knew no, no, that from on, the beginning, on, though. Hold on, he knew hold that from hold day on, one. Hold I never.
On. Hold on. Are you doomed? Yes. Because, and it doesn't absolve him from making a bad decision and choosing you, but you are not a wife. You don't have the mentality of a wife. You keep portraying and you keep pretending and you keep having these conversations like, oh, no, I'm a good girl and all of this. And you make all of these excuses. But in reality, you don't have the mindset of a person that's actually truly looking for somebody to be a life, spend a lifetime with. You just fucking around because you cute and you look good for your age and all of this. And so you out here playing cards and fucking around. You're not trying to get married. You're just trying to pretend like you are. And so now you're starting to affect other people. You fucked up your other marriage, right, with the pastor, all right? And it doesn't absolve him for being responsible also. And now you're doing the same thing with another dude that got his whole life ahead of him. And so he going to have to retrain himself to think differently about women after you because you have no intention on doing the right thing. That's just a fact, though. And so you keep telling me, am I doomed? You know, you already know the answer to your question. You know the answer to the question. You fucking around. You have no intention of marrying this dude, but you still want to hold on to it. Eventually, them looks is going to fade away because you're 52. But once you hit 62, you're going to look good for your age, but you're going to look different.
But I never got into it. And I told him from day one that I didn't want it to go as far as it has gone. And I have been telling him, and I have been saying, listen, and I have, we have broken up a million times, and I have been the one.
You don't have the mentality of a wife. You don't have the mentality of a wife. You playing games. And you know what your problem is? You know what your problem is? Your looks is your curse. Your looks is your curse. And usually what happens with a lot of these overly nice looking women or whatever that was able to hold on to their looks for an extended period of time, what happens is they don't have the mentality of a woman that actually is looking to become a wife, because they still feel like they got options and they still feel like it's available to them. And so even though they may have that understanding of knowing what they're supposed to do, they don't do it because they still think that they got options. So your mentality is not that of a woman that is supposed to be with a man for a longer period of time. You just play games.
But I wasn't playing the game. I really wasn't playing the game.
You with a dude for 5 years. You know you ain't gonna marry him.
I told
you. What are you doing with him? He must got some good. He giving you that good D, ain't he?
No, it's not even like that. I told him that.
It's not even thing about it. What you doing? You playing games?
I'm not playing games.
Why are you with him?
And I told him that I wasn't gonna marry him. That I never wanted to take his life. That I wanted him to have kids and have a family and all of that. And
so it's his fault.
I wasn't playing any games.
So is it his fault or is it your fault?
It's nobody's fault. It's nobody's fault. It's not mine. It's not his. We just ended up just staying in this place.
What's your goal?
Anton.
I really want to just be, I just want a grown life. Like, I've taken care of everybody that I've ever been with. So my husband and, my wife who's passed away, and this so now I'm just like,
what's the wife that passed away?
Yeah,
what are you talking about?
I got married.
You married a chick?
Yeah.
Jesus fucking Christ.
This was before the pastor or after the pastor?
No, this was after. No, this was after. But
this wasn't your friend, was it?
No. This was way after. But what the only thing that I'm saying is that I keep on doing these same stupid things, and I realize that. And so, is there any way to fix it? Is there any way
Can I say something? I want to say something. Let's just address the elephant in the room. You got with this young guy. A lot of times older women like to get with young guys so they can feel like they still got it. So they can feel like, you know, they still can get the attention of a younger guy. You know what
Breezy,
I'm saying?
I'm gonna pour myself a drink.
Okay. And so this is my thing, right? Let's just be honest, D. You put yourself in this predicament.
Of course.
You know, a lot of time you wanted to get your groove back.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? With the 32-year-old, knowing it was all lust. You wanted some young dick. And you wanted, you know, every now and then it was cool to be seen with this guy at a restaurant just to let everybody know you still got it. I get it, D. This Freezy. I get it.
But this is the point I'm trying to make. I'm not disagreeing with you.
Right. But this is the point I'm trying to make, D. When does it end?
It's already ended. So
no, listen to what I'm saying.
So where do I go from here? That's what I'm trying to find out. It's already ended. So where do I go from here?
Listen to what I'm saying. You was with this dude for 5 years, right?
Almost, yeah. Maybe 4 now.
The point I'm trying to make is, and I think that's the same, it's the same point Anton was trying to make. This relationship should have never happened.
Agreed.
Listen what I'm saying. Y'all was just fucking, but it's more shame on you than shame on him, because you old enough, you know what I'm saying? Not saying that an older woman can't be with a younger guy. I'm not saying that.
Of course, what I'm saying, I'm horrible.
This is what I'm saying. This guy wanna marry you. But you know you don't want no kids. You know he ain't never had kids. And I'm pretty sure you've been marinating on this for at least 3 years. You know what I'm saying? So,
oh, no, what, I've been telling him. I've been marinating. No, that's what
I know. I understand that. Listen to what I'm saying. I understand that. What I'm telling you is this. When does it end? And then you with the black church. You was with the black church. I just did a show about the black church and how the black church is one of the worst examples for black people today. And then, you know, I'm doing a show tomorrow, right, about Blueface's mom, Clarissa, and Black China's mom, Tokyo Tony. They done made rap songs against each other. They rapping against each other, and they talking about they finna fight each other and all that. These women damn near 75. and they on the internet acting like this. The point I'm trying to make is, when you spoke as a child, you did childish things. You understood as a child. You thought as a child. But when we grow
we do as adults.
When is it going to end? And then now you're asking us, what should you do? You know what the best thing you should do, D? And this is coming from love.
Just stop altogether.
Listen, this is the best thing you should do. You should cut that boy loose tonight. As soon as you get off the phone with us, call him and say, listen, it's over, right? Then it's after that, you should straighten your life up. Apply some discipline in your life, and the best thing you can do is become a better example for the young girls. Don't even think about your future right now. I'm not saying you can't get married, but you're not going to get married until you change. First of all, you got a thought demon. We talked about that the last time. You thought I was playing.
Oh,
you got a real life thought. Lustful demon. And you need to go in your prayer closet and pray that motherfucker away. I'm telling you, because that's what's getting you in trouble. But the best thing you could do right now is let that boy go tonight. And then apply discipline to your life so that younger women can have a better example. That's what you're supposed to be right now. You understand what I'm saying? You worried about getting married. Don't worry about getting married.
I'm not worried about bettering yourself. I haven't had a chance to say what I was trying to say. I'm not worried about getting married. I have already broken up with him. That is already a wrap. Anton asked me about the last time. So I was just telling him about the last time. It's not what's going on right now. And I am not looking for anybody. I have never been looking for anyone. I know better than to do that, even not having been taught all of that stuff, right? So I know not to be looking for a man and so on and so forth. I'm not doing that. I live by myself. I take care of myself. I have a great career. I have a house. I mean, I have done the things that I needed to do, not because I wanted to, but because if I didn't do it, it wasn't going to get done. And so I had to do, you know, in order to live and survive. But I never wanted, and everything that I do it in thinking of maybe one day. But at the same time, I'm just taking care of my life. And the thing with him was never meant to last this long. And I never led him the wrong way. I never told him I was interested in any of that.
Baby. Listen, D, what do you want?
I just don't want to die alone. Buy a dog and die alone. I don't want to buy a dog and die alone. I have.
Okay, so go and get with a dude.
I don't want to live with a dude that you want to enjoy here either.
Say what?
I don't want nobody that's just here either.
So what do you want then? You say you don't want to just die alone, but now you're starting to add extra parameters and saying, but I don't want a guy that's just here either. What do you want?
I just want a workable, amicable relationship.
With who?
At some point.
Define. Break it down. What do you want him to be?
I want him to be strong. and attentive and smart, somebody I can have a conversation with, because mm-hmm. I like to have intelligent conversations.
Mm-hmm.
What and else? I don't want it to just be about sex.
You want him to take care of you, or are you willing to take care of yourself?
No, I take care of myself, and I've taken care of everybody I've ever been with.
Have to live with you?
Not necessarily. I mean, not necessarily.
Do you want him to live with you?
Eventually, I would hope so, because again, I don't want to die alone. And in order for us to, I'm getting older, Anton. So at the end of the day, I do need somebody that I can share insurance with and who can decide. I have children and all of that, but who can make decisions on my behalf that's in the house with me. And eventually, I'm not saying right now.
So you want
competent. I'm going to need that, and he's going to need it as well.
Let's summarize this. So you want somebody that's competent, that you can share life stories with, hang out with, and that you can grow old with. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Then stop fucking around with 33-year-olds.
You're right.
And
you're absolutely right.
Get with and align yourself with people that is on the same playing field, that want the same things as you. And you ain't going to find them in a club. You ain't going to find them hanging out at bars. I'm speaking figuratively, right?
Oh, okay. Because I don't drink.
Find them in none of those spaces. You just going to have to be around. First of all, let me say this. You still got a lot of work to do on yourself. And so that's just going to be a lifetime of work. All of us are always going to be evolving, and we got a lifetime of work. So I'm not going to say that it's over for you for what you want. But as long as you continue to have the mentality that you have, it will be over for you, because all you're doing is eliminating the possibility of you being able to actually bond with somebody or pair with somebody that you want to be with. And so you're just going to have to chill out for a minute. You need to go back. Honestly, how long has it been since you've been in a relationship, since you was with that guy?
It just broke off like a month ago, whatever.
All right, you need to take like a year off and fix yourself. Don't get no rolls, no masturbating, no none of that. Like, you just need to literally go cold turkey, chill out, reconnect with God, get possibly, you know what I'm saying, get a mentor or somebody that can help you, and not a fucking woman. Get with a guy that can actually coach you up and give you some game. And you need to go back into the fundamentals of what it actually means to be a good person. Not even a person, a woman that's looking for a relationship, because you're not ready. You need to learn how to be happy alone. Every situation that you find yourself in, you find yourself attaching yourself to people based off of something that you need temporarily and not something that you're looking for long term. And it's because you don't even know yourself. You ain't dated yourself. You went from a pastor over to marrying a woman and then to a younger dude that you know that you wasn't supposed to be with, and you just broke up with him, and he probably still trying to call you to get some pussy. So you honestly just need to go back into the dark and figure out who the fuck you are, reconnect with God, figure out what your life is like, and then date yourself and figure out who you are. Fix all of the problems that you know that you got, and don't use any of these temporary vices to make you feel good about yourself.
Right.
When you get that together, then you will be ready to start having a conversation of who you should be with. And until then, don't ruin nobody else's life by pairing and bonding with them, knowing that you're not good for them.
Right.
So that's what I would do. That's the advice that I would give you.
Okay. I accept that.
Yeah.
I thought that was probably something that I was going to need to be doing anyway, but I just was... That was just confirmation. I had already set that, you know, that whole plan in motion to where I was not going to be dating and all that type of stuff or whatever. But just taking care of my own business. So
let me see you. Get closer to the camera. I ain't going to put you on the live stream. I want to personally see you.
Can you see me?
Yeah, let me see all of you.
No, I don't have any pants on.
Oh, fucking God.
My hair's up, sorry.
Why you ain't got no pants on?
Uh-oh. He's coming in. Cause
who, Carl? Who's that?
That is Jeremy.
Who the fuck is Jeremy?
Jeremy is the ex.
Bye, D.
Bye.
He over to the house. D gone.
I just got hung up, Freezy.
Oh, he over to the house. I thought she broke up with him a month ago. What the fuck, man?